Hey guys, it's been a long time I've uploaded any video on my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install Talk Android Nougat firmware on your S8 or S8 Plus. It depends on whichever phone you have. So well, let's get started. First of all, I'll recommend you to take full backup of your phone because we'll be resetting everything, we'll be erasing the data. So it's better you take backup of your phone because in case you have any sensitive private things, then it will get deleted, it will get erased completely. So it's very important to take backup. Find your way to settings, go to general settings and then reset. And then in there, click on factory data reset. Click reset. You will be presented with a window in which you will have to enter your password, which may be a PIN or a password. Once done, click on reset. Your phone will shut down. So as you can see, it is erasing the stuff. It is erasing the data in your phone. It will take a few seconds. Don't touch your phone. Don't do anything while the process is going on, because if you try to interfere, then it may break your phone. You need to download two files from a site called Sam Mobile. Most of you might be aware of that site. It is a very trusted site and I trust it personally. And I hope you download it from that site itself. And it's upon you, you can download from any other site as well. So you need to download the firmware. I have already extracted the zip file. And as you can see, there will be 5 files under that folder. Thing you need to download, the second software you need to download is Odin. You will get that from Sam Mobile as well. Download any version according to your choice. Once done, extract it and install it. So after extracting and installing that software and after extracting the firmware file, go to Odin, click on BL, navigate to the folder in which you have extracted the files, the firmware file, and then you will see a file name starting with BL in block letters. Click on it, wait for some time, let it load. The next thing you will do is click on AP and select the respected AP. The AP file is the main file and it will be around 5 to 6 GB. So well, the file has loaded. The next thing you will do is load the CP file, and the last file is the CSC file. You will be presented with two files named with CSC. The first one will be CSC OXM and the second one will be Home CSC OXM. The only difference between the two is that Home CSC OXM will keep your data intact and the CSC OXM will erase the file. Once the phone is started, what you need to do is just skip through all the navigation process, and then you need to go in settings, enable developers option, and in that you need to tap on the OEM lock and off it. So for entering the download mode, you need to press the power button, the Bixby button and the volume down button. You'll be presented with a warning screen. Press volume up key for continue. There you can see the system status. That if the system status is official, that means that you have an official firmware of Samsung installed. The next thing you should see is the warranty void. If the warranty void is zero, phone is not tampered with and your Knox is not triggered. Once this is done, you need to connect your phone via USB cable to the PC. So I've loaded all my files in the Odin. In the meantime, once I've connected my phone to the laptop, as you can see on my window, there is a icon box which has appeared. It is very important that that dialog box, that color appears. Once all this is done, you can go in options in the Odin software and you can click on auto reboot. So well, as you can see, I press the start key. The flashing of the firmware has started. Currently is flashing the system. It will take around 4 to 5 minutes to flash the firmware. You can just sit back and relax. One thing you should note is that do not do anything on your laptop or phone while this process is going on. One more thing you should make sure is that your phone is charged around 50 to 60%, so that while the process is going on, it doesn't get switched off. As you can see, the firmware flashing has passed. It took around 4 minutes and 11 seconds. And on the phone itself, you can see that the target has been downloading. And the downloading has finished. So for those who have not clicked on the auto reboot in the option section, they need to press the three keys, that is the home button, Bixby, and the volume down simultaneously, and your phone will restart itself. Once restarted, you will be presented with the installing system update screen. Let it install. It will again erase the data on your phone, and now your phone will restart. Wait for your phone to start. Once it's started, it will install the application, and then you will be presented with the welcome screen. And that's it. You have successfully flashed the official stock firmware on your phone. If this video helped you in any way, please do comment, please do like, and please do subscribe on my channel. Thank you. I'm signing out and goodbye.